that money.
Hey, how are you? Just visiting up this direction?
Yes, just.
Yeah, maybe we'll talk. They're supposed to have a chase at the hotel.
Something's wrong with this.
Hello.
Hey, good to see you. Hey, John, how are you?
Is this not Grant?
I would have been led by the green light. That's okay. Welcome. Good, I'm glad to see you. Glad to meet you. Welcome aboard.
We got a flight ticket.
Yeah.
I seem to have a little, that's not off.
Currently clouds out there. If I bring it, maybe it won't rain when I go back.
Well, hey, you're right.
I'm hoping it's a sign that you brought it, but what?
Yeah.
Me too.
Good.
I don't have my notes in the direction, so I'll take it this time.
This is supposed to have something.
Item number nine, I think, is Fowler Reclamation Facility.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Chairman, members of the board.
Donna's back.
Do you want me right there again?
We hear you a lot better down here.
Okay, shout. Well, I know Tim's gonna have input as well.
He talks well.
That's not what I do, so. Anyway, the commissioners had asked us to bring this back before you discuss it. If you remember back on the April 10th work session, we requested moving forward with phases 3 and 4 of the Fowler wastewater treatment plant expansion. And at that time, the board, we had sent a letter to AECOM asking for some additional information in regards to perhaps changing the type of membranes. And at that work session, the board also asked them to be looking at changing phases 1 and 2 as well. That's phases 3 and 4 that we requested. We did get information back. AECOM did respond to us. We got information on May 16th and on May 18th. And the information that they did provide did not address our questions that we had asked in our letter, and I have a copy of our letter. If you'd like to see that, what we can send out. And they did not provide any justification in changing our membrane type, nor in changing out phases 1 and 2 at this time. Our staff recommendation still remains the same, to stay with our current contract, meaning moving forward with changing out phases 3 and 4 with the GE xenon membrane type, and that AECOM replace phases 1 and 2 membranes as required for the contract. Thank you.
They provided a lot of information here. I'd like to ask.
Maybe ask a question first. We did a combination discussing 9 and 10. Looks like we do 9 before 10. Just want to accuse that. We approve yours, didn't we?
Well, John.
I think it says it probably need to be.
Be combined.
They did be combined, I think. And I'd like to hear from AECOM about what they missed, why they missed it, or whatever.
Can we combine the two of them, Kim?
Yeah, Mr. Chairman, if you wish to combine 9 and 10, you can do that. But for the record, I would prefer that be in the way of a motion to combine the items.
Before we do, can anybody think of a reason not to do combining? Not what they
make a motion to combine the discussion. I'll make a discussion of 9 and 10 together.
Second. We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. All those opposed, like sign. That passes 4-0 with Commissioner Lent being absent.
Donna, what are the questions? We had 10 questions. Yes. Which ones did they miss?
Well, they touched on a few, but they did not answer all, most of them. And we asked for it to be provided in a certain format, which they did not follow whatsoever. Commissioner Bell, it was really straightforward. They told us they have this information. Why they didn't provide it to us, I can't answer that question.
This is staying with the senior.
She's recommending we send it to you.
That's right.
Well,
that's staff recommendation.
And the real reason, big reason for that, a lot of it's timing. One thing I want to point out is since last fall, when we started looking at changing membranes, we stopped replacing the old ones. The old ones are worn out, and it's time to replace them. We were in the middle of a change-out process, and obviously, if we're going to keep changing them out, every one that replaced is less money to go toward a change-out, so we stopped. Since the first of the year, the plant's really been struggling, limping along, and we have diverted flow, I think, already to a cost of about $70,000 of our cost because the membranes can't always treat the flow. At least 1 week out of each month, we were asked to divert flow. For the last month and a half, it's almost been continuous. So we're, as we go forward, we need to get this resolved, because that's what we realized in January, is we were out of time to make changes. There's no way we could get this in and approved. So we're losing, for the last month and a half, about $1,500 a day in diverting flow. Starting August, the middle of August, we'll have the Lower Big Creek pump station back. That allowed about $1,200 a day in savings over sending the flow to Fulton County. So each, in the changeout process after August, we're going to have to start adding money to our 2012 budget, because we can't save that. So there's accruing costs. We're bleeding is the best way to put it, and we need to get this resolved and move on with whichever process, and not keep extending it. So it, you know, to boil it down, you know, on top of the daily, and I don't know what, we believe the existing membranes can be replaced faster than any changeouts, and we can at least get them in sooner than a changeout process. We do not know that. We'd have to ask Xenon. But we're being asked to contribute, and in this last proposal, the cost went up, and the number of membranes we were going to get went down. So we're being asked to contribute about $500,000 to do the changeout that we don't have to spend.
Jim, let me ask you a question. I'm looking at page 4 or 5
on
the letter provided by AECOM on May 16th.
Yes.
Okay. Item A at the bottom.
Yes.
That's to the county.
Right.
That our capacity will increase by about $1 million MGD.
Yeah, these are good questions.
The plant operator is telling us that they will expect to be able to treat another one MGD.
What we asked for was to see
what you can do with the other. We believe you can do the same thing with the others and with the C's and the D's, and that's what we needed to see to show you.
So how does Kubota filters compare? I mean, do you think the Xenon could be changed quicker and easier than going changing all four?
Do you think they can get us the 1 million gallons a day extra?
That's what we've been told. We haven't asked them, so we've heard one side, and we haven't gone out for a comparison proposal.
Here to talk about it. Didn't invite them. Why don't we postpone this and have them come in? Because the million gallons a day is worth about $1.9 million to the county. That's 1.9. I want just a minute to the county, to the taxpayers. The changeover is going to save another $1 million later on.
Well, that's not.
It's going to restore, as they said, the value, bringing it up totally. I mean, we've asked them to provide some things, and I find it hard to understand when we're talking about a 1.9, a 1 million, and a 2 million. That's $4.9 million in benefit to the owners of that system, which is the taxpayers of this county.
May I just add something here?
Because we didn't get it in a format that we asked for?
No, sir, that's not, and I'd like to go back to that, because you alluded to that. If these numbers are justifiable and easily shown, I don't know why it could not be shown to us in the format we asked, that we see through the Kubota and the GE Xenon with the questions that we asked, so the staff and technical could really look at that and see if these numbers are correct and justifiable. And that is why we asked for it that way, and that is why we really wanted it. And we've been asking for this information for quite some time. I guess I don't want to get hung up by a format, but I want to get a hung up on
numbers
that
show,
we need to see the numbers.
Numbers are real,
and
words are fuzzy.
If Xenon is, actually, this is a good indicator of the type of service they've given us in the past. Aren't they here to defend their product?
AECOM
is our contractor. AECOM is the one that is supposed to be handling our contract with them.
Why don't we let AECOM speak then? Okay. Go ahead. You seem to get caught up in these.
Address B. B was confusing. That was a big thing. Yet sounds good on that second page. $1 million. So we asked, you know, inevitable membrane conversion, and that was based on an assumption from AECOM that GE is going to stop supporting this membrane type, which they've got thousands of these out there. They said they're going to continue to support those. They've got thousands of them worldwide, and they have no intention of stopping support. So to put this statement in a letter by AECOM based on an assumption that they believe, because we just absolutely, none of us could understand where they're coming up with $1 million cost in 5 years, is just terribly misleading.
Let's ask them, there
is. And so, yes.
Yeah.
Mr. Chairman, Commissioners, let me get the timeline straight here.
Who are you?
I'm Nick Cooper with AECOM. I'm project manager and have been since the inception of the project. Just to get the time.
The project being Fowler plant, is what you're saying?
Yeah, the Fowler plant, right, the reclamation system. Just to make sure we understand the timeline, the letter that we were asked to prepare was based on our original recommendation of the Coke Puron methods, where we're just looking at a phase 3-4 addition. So when we found that what was on the table was a discussion of putting all of the, all the membranes, that made that discussion move. We could still provide you information on the Coke Puron, but the date of that was overridden by the request of the board. So we had it ready to give, and then when the board said they wanted to know what it would be for a complete changeout, that changed the hierarchy or the requirement. There's been no letter asking us to compare the Kubota with the xenon membranes. So our original statement back in March is that we were just going to add the Coke membranes because that was most economical. It fit in well with the existing system. So what we have now is a response to your request at the board meeting of April 24th.
That's when they were instructed to go with Kubota.
Right, and that's what we're responding to today, is the request that we had from the board, which obviated the other request. I mean, we're no longer talking about the Coke Puron membranes, which is what the response had to be for. So just want to get that straight. We never responded to that because we said, and we responded in the email, that was no longer on the table until we knew that this wasn't going to be considered. So we have no problem comparing the Coke membranes with the xenon, but that's not a factor right now. So what we do have is an offer that we're making to the county, and what it provides is a way of modernizing the system to the current. We had actually three different options we looked at. We had the GE Xenon 500D, which had a proposal. We had the Coke Puron, which had a similar proposal to do that. And then we had the Kubota membranes, which are a flat plate membrane. It's a different type of configuration. It's the same type that you have at the James Creek plant. And this was the recommendation of the board for us to proceed with one or the other of these process or vendors. We were directed at April 24th to proceed with the vendor for Kubota. So that was the basis of what we've done. That's the basis of the letter. And we also sent a supplemental letter which talked about the specific advantages of Kubota for this project, and that's what we did, and we follow that direction, and that's what we have in front of you. So what we're offering essentially is to take monies that you currently have planned for the expansion, which is about $940,000, and apply that towards a modernization of the whole plant. We offered to do it with any of the three vendors, and what was selected at the board was one of the vendors. So we have that cost. There's a cost that we're contributing, which is the cost of replacing membranes that we would have to incur. If we replace the old version of membranes with a new copy of the old membranes, that's money that we're expending that we won't have available later to apply towards this conversion. So
one of the vendors, which vendor? So I'm clear.
Well, the vendor that was selected at the last meeting was the Ovivo Kubota vendor, and we were asked to process that and come up with that. We said we really needed to have a direction from the board.
Just for the clear, on April 24th, the board voted to proceed with phases 1, 2, 3, and 4 with Kubota,
right,
and it passed unanimously.
I think you gave him direction to compare. I know what you said.
They were given, they were told to proceed.
We had to use one vendor. We don't want to get three.
No, that's just what you talked about. And it says there's a motion by me and a second by me to proceed with phases 1, 2, and 3 with Kubota, and for AECOM to bring back full details and full specifications to present it at the next work session.
Yeah, right.
So that's why they didn't bring that together, I guess.
Yeah,
that's why I said.
Do we have that information, though, that we've requested? Details
and
specifications.
Well, but only to compare a different membrane system. It was never to compare the Kubota system. So if we were directed to
the Water Sewer Committee.
told.
They did bring that to order.
We have the letter and we have the email that we sent.
Yeah, they did bring it to order to a committee, because they, and they even had the graphs and drawings showing the different basins, I remember.
Well, but that, yeah, the specific items that, Ms. Kukarola asked us to provide, we were prepared to provide. If the decision was made to reject the whole concept of conversion, once it was, once the conversion was the current plan on the table, it was a moot point to discuss the pure on numbers. Yeah, so when we were directed to do that, we still have that letter. And if you want, we can certainly propose the pure on membranes, but that's no longer part of the comparison.
It's not really the first time we've asked for numbers instead of words, and we just haven't. We haven't seen the numbers yet to justify recommending to the county to do it. And, you know, if you didn't understand that we wanted numbers from those questions on that day, and I see where it was going to be pure on, but I think it asked to bring back to answer the question so we could make a recommendation.
They were told to go vote and bring back justification. They did provide those, Tim. I've seen them somewhere.
That was previous at earlier meetings that they brought different things to us without the numbers that we got last.
No, they brought it, it was a...
This has changed. They're doing less now than they were then. And the number, the price has gone up than that proposal. So it changes all the time, and we just...
Well, the original proposal we gave you was in December, and here we are 5 months later. We now have essentially two turnkey projects. We're going to be putting in the membranes totally. It's going to totally managed by the Ovivo folks. They take full responsibility. And then the inflow pump station is going to be done by our other vendor.
So a screen or something?
That's an additional item that's not part of this. All right, and like I said, we would be able to give you that for any of the three vendors. We weren't willing to do independent negotiations with each.
Have we compared, like Tim said, have we compared dollars to dollars yet?
Can I address one issue, if you don't mind?
Go ahead.
In August, we were invited to contact AECOM and provide a proposal. I represent Ovivo.
Who are you, sir?
John Kiefer. We met with the staff. We, at their direction, at Tim's direction, John Marshall's direction, we contacted AECOM to provide a proposal for the replacement of membranes at Fowler. And I'd just like it to be known that our proposal was $800,000 lower than the Xenon, the existing vendor's proposal. One thing that seems to be missed is that Xenon is now given the opportunity to go back and lower their price to match ours. Had we not gotten involved in that process, would Forsyth County be looking at an $800,000 additional cost to stay with this existing vendor?
For a company that provided no service when we needed it.
That's correct.
Well,
that issue has been a question that I wanted to make sure was brought up.
I need to say, I agree with John that we asked them, and we did. We're open to this consideration, but it's not Forsyth County that would have the $800,000. It's AECOM that's on the hook for all of that cost. And there's history behind the relationship between GE and AECOM in a previous contract. So the statement, again, the letter talks about it being a county savings. It's really AECOM savings that did get recognized, but they're responsible for replacing those membranes. So
is it in their contract? Place.
Yes, we have pre-purchased, and that brings up another issue that Donna will probably talk about, is if we modify, is the fact that we've purchased a product and now we're wanting to change to a different product. Is that
okay? But Xenon said they don't produce the product that we pre-purchased. They could specially make it, but it costs more. They do make it, but it costs more because they're now making the D's over the C's.
Those membranes went up 60% in 1 year. Yeah.
So, you know,
we appealed to the county, and the county said if you can find comparable membranes that are, you know, that was back in August, and we spent the effort all the way through December to come up with those concepts. We lost 5 months in that process. And, you know, we felt there was good faith in both sides that, you know, if we can come up with something and show you that it's comparable, that you would be accepted of it. So it's only now that we're sensing that.
Well, it's not the numbers accepted. When we had numbers about the expansion, and when we cross reference back to what we hear on the other products, they can do the same thing for possibly less money. And we hear that the new Xenon membranes can provide extra expansion. So there hasn't been an independent engineered evaluation of the right numbers.
Who told you that?
Of the GE people.
Well, has he provided you anything that would document that, or is he just
They'd give us, and that's what we asked for in the rates, was these permeability rates, and we, that's what we expected them to answer back.
Where's the info from?
I mean, if you've got it, why not share it with them?
Is it appropriate to ask, that in the interest of time, I mean appropriate, I'm not going to ask you, in the interest of time, that we postpone this?
We can, it seems like there's information coming from all angles.
We just want to run out of time to change bills.
We have 1 hour left before planning commission.
Every day that we miss, it's costing.
I'm with you if you want to keep it.
No, I'm with you, no. I'd like to get the information.
This is costing us $1,500 a day.
We have to look, this costs us money in the long run.
Well, I understand that, but it seems that there's information now that we don't have to make a decision. How are we expected to make decisions if we don't have all the information?
We think ECOM has that because their first proposal.
But Tim, if we have it, why haven't you provided it to us?
It needs to go to them, we just got emails.
I've never seen anything further, I mean, I've seen one proposal.
How are we supposed to make decisions when we don't have full information? If you've got information, we need to have it.
We haven't been allowed to really submit.
You could certainly give it to me and say, look what CNOT's doing. They said they can meet it. And if you've got that, I need to know it. We can't make decisions without information.
We postpone.
We need to.
Next work session. Get some figures, need some figures.
We've got to get this done.
And then we'd like to also discuss the costing, it says like an allocation, it's not an allocation.
Okay.
Here's what I'm going to. Exact numbers.
One more time.
Not saying it's a trick, yes.
Let's go back. Would you please provide the chart that we need?
Dollar figures.
To meet the, whatever this like is. Okay? Whatever they ask for, I know that's not what you instructed last time. Let's go ahead and do the.
All three are just.
Letter dated April the 5th.
Just one.
The letter dated April the 5th, you answered the 10 questions. Let's look at the cost. Let's have Voda come in, let's have Xenon come in, and if Huron wants to participate, they need to come in and be here to answer these questions so that we can make a decision. Because I hear different things from different people. Now, I've got a letter from you, a DD, who's in this business, that tells me that you support the Kubota truck.
I say it has value to the county.
And so, you know, now we're going back and saying, well, there's information that's out there that you don't have, that I don't have, and I'm expected to make a decision on. And this is a big problem.
We were directed to look at one vendor, and that's how we did it. We did not want to do three independent. This is Lee Grant.
My name is Lee Grant. I'm a vice president with AECOM. And I happened to attend the meeting 6 weeks ago when we were directed to look at the illegal project. And so that's what we did. And this isn't just an engineering exercise. This is a construction exercise. We were asked to put together a price that's design, construction, hard bids. We've had to go to our vendors, get hard numbers. And that's why Nick was asking that question, because this was a design build exercise and effort and not just an engineering exercise. I understand the questions that were asked, but those are estimates. When you get into that point, you're looking at estimates. Any vendor can tell you anything, but you've got terms and conditions and risk allocation and all those items that need to go into that. And to ask us to do that for three separate, because they all end up having little nuances, is really putting a burden on us that I don't believe is appropriate.
And I understand that, sir, but even your letters that you just sent to us, they do not say that these are hard costs, they say they're estimated costs.
These are the costs that make up our offer.
Right, but they do not say, they do say they're estimated costs.
But we're making an offer. I mean, the point is it's an offer. This is not a cost.
And I understand that. And the reason that it says estimated is, and I can clarify it if you need to say, is because of the allocation that comes from the county. Okay, there's a number that's in there as a placeholder for that particular portion, because that's a number that came from the old contract that gets moved forward. So that part is an allocation at this part based on what we believe that number to be, and that's why we use the word estimate.
But it's on that allocation, but on these membranes that you're proposing, we don't really know the cost of those. We knew the cost of the GE Xenon, and that's how we came up with that rationale. We had the $2,002. We knew what the cost that they were at that time, and so that's why we had it based upon the CPIU to bring that cost up to current dollars.
But that's not just the Xenon. That was our responsibility to deliver a membrane.
Equal
the county added a specific requirement to have that as Xenon. And now Xenon comes back and says, in the original pricing, that it's going to be $800,000 more. That's when the other vendors started to come in, and the pricing from Xenon came down. It came down. So all of these things end up into the mix, and it's not one of those clear-cut type of scenarios. I certainly understand that. And so to go back and provide estimates for these other pieces and parts, that's not even fair to our partners now with Ovivo, because we have hard numbers that are out in the internet public.
And I understand, but I'm going to go back to these questions, and I apologize, Commissioner Mills, I know you don't want to hear it.
It's not that I don't want to hear it, it's just that on April 24th, the board gave a different direction. And forgive me, Donna, but the board has given direction.
I understand, sir. But I also heard that, and I know you gave direction to go to the Kubota, but I also heard you to answer the 10 questions when you were talking about it. Please answer these questions.
On the 24th?
Yes, sir.
No,
on the 10th. I apologize, the 10th. Okay. I'm sorry, on the 10th. And these questions that I'm talking about, a lot of them, sir, are not cost indicative. They're not cost driven. They are about the capabilities of the membrane. That's the majority of these questions, sir. So I just would like you to realize that.
I really thought we were going to compare and compare them to Xenon, see what kind of true cost savings we want to have.
We specifically said.
That's why I speak.
We have to also recognize that we're not here on a daily basis. There's a huge disconnect between our staff and AECOM. Huge disconnect. That shouldn't exist, but it does. I don't know whose fault it is, but it's not fair to either. We've got a huge water treatment plant that is just sitting there while we have this disconnect. And I'm concerned about it more than anything.
We're losing money,
and we seem to have an attitude that if they lose money, we don't care. As a matter of fact, if we can make them lose money, we're happier with that. And I've heard that statement, and I'm not happy with that statement. So I have a hard time accepting the recommendations. Now, I hate to sit here in public and say that, because I don't like to throw our staff under the bus in public, but I have heard those, and I don't think
how hard it is to get numbers. That's all I'm saying.
We would
have to get contractors in to price it up as if it was another system. And that's
adding additional cost on us.
Yeah, that cost is.
What do you think it costs to do that? Just
you mean to do the estimates?
To get all this put together.
Well, I mean, I'm just here the first time. I guess the point is I have a complete estimate that covers all the elements involved.
There's something more than these 10 questions going on here. I don't know what it is.
And I have no problem with answering those 10 questions if it's going to be on the boat. I can do that today.
Right.
But that wasn't, we were told that was no longer. This was just for phase 3-4. That's all that was intended.
So, but again, they would have to be based on, I'm thinking out that if you don't mind.
I don't know why we continue to do this when we continue to have documentation over and over and over and over, and that it saves money, that it increases capacity.
To be honest, we were given, the good faith on our side was we assumed that the board was directing us to look at one system. If it was cost effective, make the change, you would. If not, then you don't. And to have us do another and another option, I think at some point the board's going to have to make that directive. We said at the time, this is your asset. You have to make that choice. If you chose Xenon and that was the option, we would price that up and tell you what that.
And I have to remind you that all of us here, it was a unanimous vote to do this. It wasn't my vote or your vote.
I thought this got back to figures. Hard figures. I agree. Functional compared cost.
Well, we're giving you a firm. We're saying this is our offer. How much we would need you to contribute. We're donating to this cause $450,000 plus the cost of cleaning that we've had to do in all these months that we've lost. Probably about 8 months that we've been cleaning. That's all donated. All my time is donated. So, for us to say here, this
and
is the exact.
It's a separate item. We also have to consider this screen.
But what's
the
cost plus for Xenon? Are we going to contribute another $450,000 for Xenon?
No. I think that's part.
Yes,
of
you would.
Important part. Yes, we would.
They said no.
If you elect to make the conversion, which is what Xenon was talking about, that's what Xenon was proposing.
Xenon goes to five. Xenon is
that
proposed.
True?
Five
brand new system.
We can stay with the current membranes.
Why would we want to stay with old technology?
They're just different size. They're not a lot different.
Then why'd they quit making them?
They have
the 500 C's?
No.
They were here, Tim, and they said that we quit making them, but we'll make them in limited quantities that people are going to use.
These are cheaper, and so most anybody who orders them is going with these.
And why are they cheaper? Because they're making more of the D's and they're making limited C's. Because they're transferring everybody over to D's from C's. They're cheaper because they make more, because they quit making the C's.
But they may have had a contract with Xenon for the price of these phases 3 and 4, I don't know.
It's hard to put numbers together. It's been that hard to put numbers.
Well, we wouldn't think so.
We don't have access to the numbers. They're coming through AECOM, who are dealing with the membrane manufacturers.
We did this in December, and we gave you an offer in February and March, and we showed the comparative numbers of the three options.
But, I mean, they're buying seeds now for the replacements. I mean, we've gotten some numbers from Xenon. We have to buy them at the Manor plant. That's what the Manor plant has. So we can get a price to what it would take to stay just like we've got and put C's and not go to the
D
style.
Yeah, let's give
and,
them do that.
We can get a price from them directly to us.
And you want to get the D's as well?
C's and D's. That's, I don't know how.
We get the price.
D's that require modifications. We can look at the change out in a few years, and that's what we would recommend.
I'm sorry?
Price of Kubota's. Price that out.
It's already been done. You know, all that work.
But it's already, that's been already done.
Right.
We've already done all that.
Commissioner, to be clear, you're asking us to get a price to stay with C's for phase 3 and 4.
Because we already got C's in 1 and 2.
Yes, sir. And that will then necessitate AECOM going back and fulfilling their contractual obligation to make the membranes in 1 and 2, phases 1 and 2, fully operational.
Mm-hmm.
So that's included at their cost.
That does that involve cleaning them or replacement?
Replacement.
At their cost.
As they wear out.
Do we want to put 500 C's in the third and fourth basins? Do we want to put old technology in?
We're getting prices first. We'll get prices.
Do we even want to consider it? Do we want to waste the time to put old technology in the new basins? That's what I'm getting at.
Yeah, we studied that. And obviously, to start with, we like the D's. They allowed a little more space later on for expansion. But you can do that conversion to Xenon in 8 years if you want to go to D's, and they're already working on a Model E. So by the time we really need the capacity, all of these membranes will be being replaced again. We don't have anywhere to put the flow
even,
now. So
one thing I'm
even
so the C's are taller, and they pack them together, and they do have a little higher permeate capability, so they can squeeze more additional cassettes in the same tank. And that's their advantage.
And we want to see the additional capacity, because I have a great concern that we've oversold the capacity. We know we have. We've got the spreadsheets to show it. And this million will allow us to do one of two things. Either sell capacity, $1.9 million worth. More than that, it's $1,019 shelf. It's $19 million, right?
Yes.
$19 million worth of capacity.
Well,
I thought 1.9. But a million gallons a day, that's...
A million gallons a day is $19 million. But we don't have anywhere to put it, so...
But that's okay. Or we've set ourselves to meet the obligations where we've already oversold.
And right. Well,
so I want to see that we get... I want to see what capacity we get from these other ones.
If somebody want to make a motion on this, we've got about 20 minutes.
You might postpone it. Just postpone it. I make a motion we postpone it to January.
I think we ought to call a water and sewer committee and get to the bottom of it, because I'm sick of coming in here and getting conflicting information.
Okay, you can do that. But let's postpone January 12th. Maybe you can have a June 12th.
Second.
Let me. The staff, the direction from the board for staff as of today is what? Postpone and do what? I want to make sure everybody's clear.
Compare, we get some official numbers from 3 and 4, and then finishing up 1 and 2 back to type C's. And then I guess price type D's out, and then get a price on Kubota filters and what the capacity of the plant will increase to.
Isn't part of that exercise then for AECOM to justify to the county deviating from the current contract?
Yes.
Okay.
These are justifications.
Deviating from the contract?
No, they're
is there justification?
I don't know if it's a deviation or if it's a
justification.
Well, let's be fair. It's not a. I know we've been talking about this capital already. It's an option that we can either use the 500 C's or the D's or the Buronco or the Xenon.
I mean, or the Kubota.
Kubota. Cost associated with that. And then what we would be looking for is a justification to spend above what we currently spend on the contract.
That justification comes from, if we're going to spend an additional $13,000 in my office, where do we get a return on that investment? Because we can't spend money without a return on investment.
I mean, all of the options we looked at had much more capacity than the current option. Okay, we have to start with that.
We'll need to put that all in paper, put some figures down. If you'd have water, sorry.
This has already come through the water service committee, and it came up with a recommendation to use Kubota's. The board's recommending Kubota's, and for some reason, we keep getting new information every time we meet. So, whatever you guys want to do.
You understand, can you do that for us?
Are we postponing this?
Yes. June 20th.
We have a motion and a second to postpone. If there's no further discussion, please hold on the motion. All those in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, like sign. That passes 4-0.
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to bring something up.
Yes.
We need to go ahead and set up a meeting for tomorrow afternoon or Thursday morning. Anticipating, I think, what the mayor had said at their city council meeting this morning. He was waiting on our offer. Obviously, you know, there's a possibility he may counter our counter, his counter,
all right,
our
so,
counter, or our counter.
So, when
so
you
I, thought, I was going to suggest Thursday morning.
Well, do we want to set up a tentative time for tomorrow and then a tentative time for Thursday?
Well, I think we figure we give them tomorrow to review it unless he's going to meet tomorrow afternoon.
Well, my only concern is let's say he gets it. Let's say he has it now and he's already made changes and ends it. Then we wasted Wednesday.
Sure, that's fine. All right, we'll meet tomorrow.
I can't meet tomorrow. I mean, you know, we could, you know, you don't need me here, but that would be